This stuff keeps showing up, so I'm going to keep opening it. It's mailbag time again. Let's see what we've got. All right, let's start with this one. Oh, actually, first, let's start by opening this. Okay, get my knife. Oh, different knife today. So this one says, description of contents, plaything, total grass weight, 0.08 kilograms. And it's noisy, it's rattly. Oh, this is a little package of a whole bunch of really small screws and nuts. These are smaller than normally you'd use for electronics. They are, in fact, intended for my modeling. I wonder just how tiny those are. Hang on. Okay, so these little guys look to me to be about a millimeter by 5 millimeters long. And it looks like there's two different sizes in here. So what are these other guys? Oh, and a couple of different lengths as well. And what are these guys? Yeah, they look bigger to the eye, but yeah, maybe millimeter and a half. And again, 5 millimeters long. Okay. So then that looks like a huge amount. That's a lifetime supply, basically. And now I can bolt together wee tiny things for my model railroading. Cool. So here we have useful 12 kind 600 pieces of stainless steel screws nuts assortment kit. 12 kinds, huh? Well, it looks like there's 12 different compartments in there. Yeah, two compartments of nuts, a few different sizes of screws. What does it say about it? 600 pieces? Does it say... Oh, it does, too. Good. So, 1.2, 1.4 millimeter nuts, or M1.2, 1.4. Screws, M1, M1.2, 1.4, in various different lengths. Nice. Okay. And that was from LICN 2011, who I've never bought from before, but this was just randomly cheap. And was it really $4? Did I pay that much? Or $5.58 Canadian? All right, next up, we have electrical plugs adapters. Aha. So standard 2.5 millimeter tip ring sleeve. These ones are metal rather than the cheap plastic junky ones. Let's zoom in a little bit here. Okay, and so there is a little insulating sleeve in there. That's good. Slips over there. And then a little springy strain relief. That's nice. Those look actually pretty decent. The headphone jacks, or officially, silver 3.5 millimeter 1/8 stereo TRS male audio jack plug adapter connector. It's not an adapter, it's a connector. It's a solder-on connector. From Hero Neo 2012. Again, somebody I've never ordered from before. These came fairly quickly, though. I ordered them in June, and here we are in July, and they showed up. That's not bad. Not compared to some of the stuff around here. Those screws that were in the previous segment, I ordered those in May and they showed up in July. Anyway, back to these. Sorry, diversion. Not much to say about these that I didn't already say when I was looking at them. Solid metal, A spring is a strain relief. Good, good. Next says Model Light. Worth 78 cents. If this is what I think it is, cost me quite a bit more than that. Well, not a huge amount more, but a certain amount. And that one I won at an eBay auction. So, yeah, it is. Let me just get these guys out of here. A whole whack of LEDs and resistors, which are worth very, very little in cash. But, and we'll zoom back in here. It is three aspect signal heads. So, you mount up one. What we got for colors here of the LEDs? Put a green at the top. Basically traffic lights for trains, right? And amber in the middle. And where's the red? Actually, no, that's backwards. Green to the bottom. Red to the top. Something like that. And then you mount those right beside the rails in a yard situation or something similar. Although three aspect, have to see if North America actually uses that. I may have to modify these and mount them up on top of some kind of a mast or something. Not obviously exactly like that, but mounted up on top of a mast, which would probably be more realistic for North America. These, I believe, came from a seller who was at least claiming to be UK. Obviously, the shipping was from Hong Kong, but anyway, that's good. And some resistors. I can't really read it very well. Is that brown, black, red, something like that? Well, let's just see if I can quickly put my hands on my component tester. And there it is. Let's get a quick idea if that is what I think it is, but it's testing. Yeah, 1K. So they're assuming you're going to be using these with probably a 12 volt supply off a model railroad power pack. But I mean, it's an LED, it's just a normal little set of LEDs. Okay, there's that guy. These greens are going to be pretty washed out. I'm not sure how well you're going to be able to see that on the camera with it being. And where's color number three? Yeah. That's going to be cool. Okay, this one I did buy as an auction. For $3.64 was my winning price back in May, and it's now July. So it took quite some time. From EveModel_ES, which sounds like they're trying to make it think like, you know, sound like they're in Europe. But really, location item, Shanghai, China. Free shipping though. $3.64 was my winning bid. They had them a bunch of different sizes of these on auction at the time. This is the only one that didn't exceed my lowball bid. They're actually fairly pricey if you go to buy them normally. But like I said, they don't really follow North American prototype exactly, but I can modify them because those are nice little castings. I cut the base off and mount them on a mast. That's their 3D model of them. I guess they're 3D printed. I didn't really look carefully at them. But there we go. They're sized to take a 3mm LED. Brand new. Perfect for railway building layout. Three-light vertical block dwarf signal heads with red, green, and yellow LEDs. These LEDs are suitable for use at 3 volts only. Do not use them on 12 or 16 directly. Must connect the resistor in series. and I will supply compatible resistors for free, which he actually did. Reference size, they claim to be somewhere between 1 to 76 and 1 to 100, which HO is right in the middle of that at 1 to 87. Oh man, I'm rusty. I should have just been able to pull that right out without hesitating at all. And next we have electronic parts. Aren't they all? That's about as generic as it gets. From Hong Kong again. What we got here? Ah! I'd forgotten that I'd ordered that. How does it say when I received that? July 6th I received it. Does it say when they sent it? No. I'll have to take a look. But that one has been forever in shipping. So this is one of those Chinese ripoffs of the PCB ruler that Adafruit, I think, has, and some of the other electronics wholesalers, and a few other people have done different versions of it. But it's got the different layouts of the of some of the more common larger surface mount chips, QFP32 in a couple of different sizes, 100s and a couple BGAs on this side. So we have wire gauges all the way from 28 up to 8. Where's a, for instance, okay, here's a piece of telephone wire, which I think is going to be something like a 24 gauge. Yes, it is. There we go. So that could come in handy. And then just some general purpose circuit symbols down there. Some more SOIC, SSOP, different surface mount packages for chips. 8, 14 or 16 pin. Some surface mount transistor packages up to the larger heat sinkable transistors and some of the normal smaller ones. SOT 89, SOT 23, and then two pin packages for resistors, diodes, and whatnot, all the way down. And then if you're going to be ordering circuit boards, trace width, and then just inches and millimeters scales. That is nice. The PCB ruler, version 2, 6 inches for electronic engineers, geeks, makers, and Arduino fans. Okay, I'll take the geeks and makers thing. I like Arduino, but I wouldn't call myself a fan exactly. Anyway, whatever. From LS110 1983, aka TX Hang Electronic, somebody I buy from on a fairly regular basis. And I've ordered stuff more recently from them, and it showed up quickly. This one I ordered back in February, and again, showed up in July. Wow. I don't think it's the seller's fault. I don't think it's eBay's fault. I blame either Canada Post, China Post, or Canada Border Services and their inspection procedures at the port. But you'll never know. Nobody's going to admit to being the one slowing down the shipping. What does it have to say about it? Material printed circuit board. Font guide size. Track trace width diagram. Set of AWG size drills. Ah, centimeter marks. Yep. PCB reference ruler. Not too bad for $1.50. Yeah. I'll get some use out of that. All right, what's next? It is gift, which they say was $2. We'll just see about that. Okay. Same shrink packaging or shrink kind of tape that we've seen before. Oh. That's a bunch of three-pin DuPont header kind of ends. Well, let me just go to, where is my... Here's the assortment that I've already got going on. So basically, you crimp the end onto a piece of wire and then shove down there, and you've got a 3-pin that'll plug onto header pins. Where's some header pins? There's some over there. I'm going to just plug onto standard 0.1-inch header pins like that. And the point of these, at least for me, is to go onto the... now where did those go? Those optical detectors that you've seen me use before for the track. Hang on, just going to pause here for a second and find where I stashed them. Well, that was more of an ordeal than I thought. These things. They come like that. I've been modifying them like that. And then they've got power ground and signal out. Just like that. So I can use those with this pile of three conductor cable that I got a couple mailbags back and extend these across to my Arduino, which is going to do the track signaling, monitoring, and switching for me. Excellent. 100 pieces of 3-pin DuPont jumper cable wire housing female pin connector, blah, blah, blah. From GC Supermarket. And I remember at the time I ordered a bunch of 2-pin, a bunch of 3-pin, a bunch of male crimps, and a bunch of female crimps. And so far, only these 3-pin ones have arrived. And again, this was a March order, and this just showed up a week or so ago in July. Wow. So GC Supermarket, $1.71 for 100. Not too bad a price. Certainly better than I could get it anywhere in North America. Not much to say. They are just DuPont jumper wire header pin, header chassis, shells, whatever. All right, next up, it says mobile phone accessories. And it is, in fact, a spudger. Ah. Okay, so I ordered that at the same time as I ordered this pair of spudgers that I opened in my last mailbag several months ago, and they finally showed up. This one, it's got kind of a padded grip on it. So this one is bendier, it's slimmer, it's actually narrower than the blade of an X-Acto knife. And it's got one angle that's the same as that and one that's wider. These ones are a little bit thicker. They don't bend. Well, I'm sure I could bend them if I really tried, but it would be a one-way bend. This guy, though, is kind of flexy. And I'm guessing stainless steel. No, not stainless steel. Magnets stick to it. This one's stainless steel? Nope. Is anything stainless steel? No, that's aluminum. Okay, GB-5A, Unlimited Innovation, the opening tool. The spudger, opening spudger metal pry tool for mobile phones, tablets, iPhone, iPod, repair, steel. For 99 American cents or $1.24 Canadian from Katie's Kitty, something like that. More free shipping from Hong Kong. Brand new, spudger opener, about 120 millimeters or 4 3/4 inches. Yeah, 11 grams, sure. Stainless steel? And silicone, yeah, the silicone kind of for the grippy padded handle thing in the middle. Stainless steel, not any kind of stainless, any kind of quality stainless steel that I'm familiar with, because normally those aren't magnetic. Anyway, that's what they claim it is. Application, mobile phones, pads, watches, or other precision devices. And I think the last one for today. It says robot car electronic DIY kit. Oh, cool. I actually remember ordering this. It was, again, quite a while ago. So, what do we got in here? Oh, motors and chips and wheels and wires and documents and. Okay, so we got a little two AA cell battery box. Got two of these cheesy little hobby motors, which are, oh, they're the same as these ones that I've already got. But these ones that I already got a while ago have bigger wheels on them. These ones come with, oh, a whole bunch of goodies. A couple of fairly small wheels that just slip on there and then screw on. Okay. Gearhead motors. We got a couple of red LEDs, a clear LED, a couple of photoresistors, a couple potentiometers, a screw with an acorn nut, which is likely going to be a skid for the other end, and another nut. Oh, there's another clear. Okay, we have a chip socket. Oh, there's a push on, push off button, a couple of capacitors, an assortment of resistors of those nasty little bluish kind that nobody can read, metal films, and a couple of transistors. And what is the chip? Excuse me, hold on, just read this off. LM393. Okay, and oh, there's a circuit board that doubles as a mounting plate. Ah, these guys are self-adhesive, so they'll stick on there. Okay, nifty cool, and a uselessly short piece of wire, screws. That's cool. Let's see. What the paperwork has to say for it. Oh wow. That feels like newsprint rather than normal paper, and all conveniently written in Chinese, which is useless to me. Aha, but it's a line follower, and they give you a line for it to follow. Okay, so is going to be interesting. Just say on there. LED D4 and D5, resistor M1, M2, resistors transit. Oh, the transistors are 8550 PNP transistors. Looking at that. We have a couple of LEDs in parallel with the motors, so you can tell which motor's on, I guess. These motors only drive one direction. The LM393 is a dual op amp by the looks of it. So that's just being used to drive those two. Okay, so the inverting input of one is connected to the non-inverting of the other and vice versa. Two sensitivity adjusters up there, and two LEDs and two GR, which are the photo resistors, the light dependent resistors. Okay, that's pretty straightforward. So basically, you're shining the two LEDs straight down at your racetrack here, and the photoresistors are either seeing lots of light from a reflection. Or not so much light from the black stripe. that'll be a cool little kit to put together. The DIY smart tracking robot car electronic kit with reduction motor set. Yeah, it is those things. This one is a bit more expensive than what I normally buy, but it's got a lot of bits and pieces in it, so I think I'll give it a pass. $7.90 Canadian from China, from whoever the seller was on Banggood this time. And we can compare it against some other similar things. There's one for $8. One with tank treads for $20. Ooh, tank. Anyways, track width 15 millimeters, color as shown, two AA batteries, working voltage 3 volts, which makes sense with two AA batteries. Step 1, welding. Step 2, mechanical assembly. Step 3, installation of a photoelectric circuit, photosensitive resistance, and light emitting diodes. Note polarity. That's kind of assembly instructions, even vehicle debugging. Right direction is along the universal wheel direction. If you press and hold the left photoresistor, the wheels on the right side should be rotated, and vice versa. Okay, so basically, by when it sees the line, when it sees darkness, then it turns away from it. So those two photoresistors basically straddle the black stripe, and as long as it doesn't see the black stripe or a lack of reflected light from the LEDs, then it just keeps going the direction it is. Neato. Ooh, quick to watch the installing and debugging video. I'll be doing that when it's time to build it. And that is today's mailbag of items. Well, it's a completely random assortment this time. Cool. Thanks for watching.